All right, so we have Dhanashree Bhushan Sanket who joined in. Chalo, we will start the session. This question was complete here. Okay, any questions on this, by the way? Any questions, any doubts on this? Is it clear completely? Okay, chalo. This is the next set. Try this. I'll give you 5 minutes of time. Try this first. Any answers, anyone getting it? Bhushan says second runner up. Okay. Others, any answer? Are you guys still solving, or should I go ahead? Should I solve it? Okay, so let us start. So over here it is said that 9 horses participated in a horse tournament. Okay, 5 races were held in the tournament. Okay, and they have given you that the winner of the winner gets 5 points. Okay, first runner up get 3 points, second runner up get 1 point, the others don't get any point. Table below shows points earned at the end of the tournament. So each 5 races were held in the tournament. Okay, so we know that one race is held between 5 horses. The first race is being held with the first 5 horses from the left. That means race number 1 is between is by A to E. Okay, race number 2 is from B to F. Okay, race number 3 is from C to G. Okay. Race, this is from D to H, and the last race is like this, which is going to be here like this, right? All right, so a better way to plot this is if I have to just put the names. Okay, so I can put a table like this. So let's say you have A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and I. Okay, I'm just making a table like this. Mm-hmm. All right, and so what happens is how many races we can put all the results also here. So this is race number one, this is race number two, this is race number three, this is race number four, and then we have five. Okay, now can anyone tell me here, okay, can anyone tell me here that in race number one, who is the winner? Who is the winner of race number one? One, two, three, four, and five. Good one. Yes, A is the winner because you have seen that A has run only one race. A was a part of only one race, which is the first race, and A has got 5 points. That means A was the winner here. Okay, so A gets 5 here. Okay, apart from this, A is not there in any of the other races only. Okay, A is not there. All right, when it comes to B, B has got again 5 points. B has run two races, okay, and it's got 5 points. That means B is the winner of the second race. And apart from that, okay, B is not a winner anywhere. Okay, and anyways, B is only two races that B has run. So other cases is just a cross. Okay, clear with this also B. Now, C has got 8 points. That means how can an 8 be made? Because we have 5 points, we have 3 points, and we have 1 point. So how can an 8 be made? 5 plus 3, okay, 5 plus 3, this is how you can make a 8. Now first race winner is A, second race winner is B. That means 5 that C has got is only and only in the third race. Okay, and C has run total of how many races? Only 3 races. So this is gone. Now understand, okay, here you have two areas left, okay, and you know that 3 is going to come. There's one more clue given to you here, that it is given that H is the only horse that has that scored in consecutive races. Now tell me, based on this clue, ye jo 3 points hai, C ka jo 3 points hai, this will come in which race? Race number one or race number three? Tell me this. Race number one or race number two? Sorry, race number one or race number two? In which race this is going to come? Are you guys clear with that clue? Are you guys clear with the clue? What is said that? It is given that H is the only horse that is scored in consecutive races. That means agar maine ye jo 3 points hai, isko maine agar second race mein kar diya, to 3 or 5 consecutive race ho jayega. And C cannot have that because H is the only horse that has scored in consecutive races. That means 3 will come here and this is 0. Okay. So this way I have got the pointers for the first 3 horses. Similarly, doing it from bottom also is very easy. Okay, now I has scored 0. Okay, firstly, I has run only the last race, and which also I has got 0 points. Okay, acha, H has got 10 points. How can a 10 be made? 5 plus 5. That's the only possibility. Okay, and H has ran two races from the last. Okay, so H has got 5 and 5. And S is the only horse, okay, that has scored in consecutive races. So I can make a 5-5 here. Rest all, okay, H anyways has not ran the other first 3 races. That goes off. G becomes 4. How can a 4 be made? 4 can be made as 3 plus 1. That's the only way. Okay, 3 plus 1. Now, G has run 3 races. G has run 3 races, okay. So this is cross, 3 races are there, okay. Now, I don't know whether which is 1, which is 3, but we know this thing, that this is going to be definitely 0. It is going to be 1/3 or a 3/1. Okay, I hope you guys are understanding till this point of time. Okay, 1/3, 0, and 3/1. Okay, now that we have got this, okay, we have only 3 horses left now, which is D, E, and F. Okay, which is D, E, and F. We have just 3 horses left. Now, how can a D has got 2 pointers. That means D is going to have a score of 1 plus 1. Okay. E has got 5. F has got 6. Now, F has run in how many races? F has run in 4 races. D has run in 4 races. E has run in 5 races. Okay. E has run in 5 races. Now, tell me this. F ka jo 6 hai. F ka jo 6 hai. How can this be made? This can be made by a 3 plus 3. Okay. This was for D. This is for F. Now, F has got four races. Okay, F has got four races. And two races going to get three and three. And obviously, that is going to be alternate. That is going to be alternate only. Okay. So, here if you see, can anyone tell me, by the way, which are the races in which F can score? Because you know that in this case of D also, D is scoring 5. How can D score a 5? Okay. D can score a 5 only by having a 3, 1 and 1, right? 3, 1 and 1. This is the only combination possible for E. E cannot have a direct 5 because we have anyways got the winner of all the four races. Okay, we have got the winner for all the four races. Now, you know that it is going to be alternate, okay, for E. So, these two are going to be 0. The other places, it is going to have either 1, 3 and 3. So, here, because 5 and 3 is already gone, E can be the one. E can be the one here. Okay. And then D becomes 0 here. Now, D is 0. There are only two other places left. This is 0. This is 1. This is 1. Right, everyone? I hope you guys are getting. Anytime you're not getting anything, do ask. Okay. So, because the sequence in which you are getting data is also important. All right. Now, we are left with, we have put already, this one is put here. And then from E, we have left with 1 and 3. F, we are left with both the 3s. Okay. Now, here what happens, I don't know. This 1 and 3 is there. Here also, you can have a 1/3. And here also, you can have a 1/3. Okay. That depends here. Okay. Where it goes, we don't know. The other thing is left is 2 3s are left. 1 3 can come here. 1 3 can come here. Okay. This is 0. Okay. This is 0. And with this, the pointers are clear. Put a quick yes if you guys are clear with this. Put a quick yes. If you guys are clear, I mean, by any chance, if you are not clear, you have any doubts. Sanket says yes. Okay. Bhushan, yes. Dhanashri, are you clear? Yaksh, are you clear? All right. Now, what is the position of F in race 4? Okay, race number 4, F. F is scoring 3 points. 3 score points means what? The answer is first runner up. The answer is first runner up. Okay. Chalo, what is the ratio of the points scored by G and E in race 5? Okay. G and E in race 5. G is this, E is this. In race 5. What is the answer? Tell me. What is the answer? Cannot be determined. Good one. Because we don't know, the answer option can be 3:1 or 1:3. It can be anything. All right. First three rankers of the race 3 in some order, okay? Race 3 ke first three rankers. So, race 3, you have G, you have E and you have C. G, E and C, okay? Which is option number 1. D earned his points in which? In rank 1 and 3. D earned his points. D has earned 2 and 4. It is to be race. It should be race. Not rank. It's race. Okay. Yeah, race hona chahiye. The answer is 2 and 4. All right. Okay. With this, put a quick yes that you guys have understood the entire set. And I'll give you some more interesting sets. Okay. Yeah, this is also an interesting set. Do you want to take note of the previous one? Okay, or should we go ahead? All right. So this is the question in front of you. Take 5 to 10 minutes of time. See if you guys can solve it. These are the questions here. You guys can take note of these questions as well, because this is going to be useful. Okay, so I'll suggest you to take a screenshot of this and then look at it here. Chalo, let's start. Anyone getting it? Okay, definitely. Yes, Sanket, have a look at it. So Sanket, Bhushan, are you guys, if at all you guys are not getting, put a no and then we can look at the question together. Okay, so just look at the way we are approaching. What it is said, it's a buy two, get one free offer. Okay, and it is said that a customer can select three shirts of his choice. Okay, and pay only for two most expensive t-shirts. Okay, among the three. That means if at all you are bringing three shirts, okay, the two most expensive shirts you have to pay. And the third shirt, which is probably of a lesser cost, for that you don't have to pay. All right. So here it is said that all three shirts of a particular brand cost the same. That means if you buy anyone who's buying the t-shirt of the same brand, okay, then obviously he's paying only for two shirts. One shirt is free. Okay. All right. Also, at least two of the three t-shirts that he buys have to be of the same brand. Okay. At least two of the three shirts that he buys, okay, have to be of the same brand. All right. Chalo. Now that gives me a very clear understanding of this table also. A sheet is provided to every customer who enters the store. This contains the price of all combinations of three t-shirts that a customer could buy. Abhijit, a regular customer at the shop mall, gets the sheet, but some values is missing. Okay, instead of asking another sheet, he tries to fill this, okay, based on the reasoning skills. Now understand, can anyone tell me which particular brand should I pick up first? Which brand should I pick up first? Anyone? Based on the table, tell me this, anyone? Brand number three. Why brand number three, Sanket? If you see, you are getting brand number six, one shirt from here, two shirts from here. That means you are buying three shirts at the price of 520. You're buying three t-shirts at the brand of brand six at 320. And obviously all the three shirts are of the same price. And this 520 is the cost price of, or the selling price of, two t-shirts, right? So what is the value of brand 6? What is the value of brand 6? Anyone? What is the value of brand 6? Can anyone tell that? 260. Perfect. Good one. Okay. Which is nothing but 520 divided by 2. Okay. 520 divided by 2. So we have got brand 6. We have got. Okay. Now other things, it is kind of now a chain reaction. Okay. Because other things which are linked up to brand 6, we can get that faster. For example, okay, if you see brand 6 is also linked up with brand number 1. Okay. Now, that means one t-shirt of 6 plus 1 plus 2 t-shirts of brand 2. Okay. This is coming him for a cost of 580. Now, understand, one scenario is the case where brand 1 is going to be cheaper than brand 6. Now, this is 260. Okay. This is 260. Now understand what I'm doing is, okay, just understand the way I'm approaching, because I don't know what is the cost price of brand 1 right now. Okay. So what can be scenario? This 520 can be of this both, or can be from this two. So let me take a scenario where it is from 6 and 1. If that is the case, listen carefully, 580, I do a minus of 260. I will get brand 1 ka price from this. What is the brand 1 ka price from this? Tell me. How much is this going to be? Are you guys there? Are you guys getting it? Sanket? Yes. Okay. So this would have been 320. B1 is 320. Okay. Now understand, if B1 is 320, this is also 320, addition of both these 320 would have been 640 here, because the two most expensive shirts they are buying, right? That means that is not satisfying this condition. So what is satisfying here is that case that brand 1 is actually cheaper than probably this, or rather this 580, not cheaper, but this 580 is completely from brand 1 only. So what will be the value of brand 1? Brand 1 is going to be 580 divided by 2, which is going to be 290. Getting the point how we got it? Sanket, Bhushan, okay, just put a quick yes if you guys are getting it. So humko B brand 1 bhi mil gaya. Theek hai? Perfect. Now, can you guys continue with that same logic? Okay, and get the values for other brands as well. Now, you know, brand 1, you can calculate for brand 4 also. Now, calculate for brand 4. Okay, same way. Okay, and see if it is satisfying, then fine. If not, okay, then you'll have to divide it and then get the answer. Chalo. Try karo. Tell me the value for brand 4 now. Okay. So one of brand one, which is 290, one of brand 4. Okay. This is 550, 250. The total is going to be 540. Perfect. What is the next that we can find out now? B3. Yes, B3 all we can find. Or B3 we can find out from here. B1 is this, B4 is this. B3 is linked to B2 and B6. Achha, haan, B6 se linked. Haan. Toh yahan se hum B3 la sakte hain, yes. B3 is 350. Okay, cool. Now B3 and B6, if you see two shirts of B6, okay, and one shirt of brand one. Okay, if you are saying that B3 is 350, okay, one shirt of B6 is 260, how come you are getting 700? 350 nahi hoga na? Haan, 350 nahi hoga. That is what I said. Check properly. Tell me again. What is the answer? Yes, it is 440. Good one. Chalo. Ye aa gaya, B3 aa gaya. Ab B3 se B2 nikal sakte ho. Tell me the value for B2. Whatever, so now you can tell me B4, okay, B2, B5 is left, okay, then you can do B7, okay, like this, and then you can do B8. Chalo, whatever, get me the values. Right, B7 430, good one. B8 batana, B8. So that I can check that B7 and B8 were a combination. Whether you have got it right or not. B5 is how much? 5 is 560. Okay. So let me check whether the numbers are proper. हाँ मुझे भी लग रहा था. So B8 is this, B7, okay. So 430, yes, this is 790 बराबर. Okay, and then we look at this na value. Okay, so B7, B8 हमने चेक कर लिया. यहाँ पे B5 चेक करते हैं. B5 is this is 1000. B3, two t-shirts, which is 440. And you have B5 as 560. Perfect, okay. Cool, ठीक है. चलो आई थिंक दिस इज द मेन पार्ट ऑफ द सेट. ओके वंस यू गेट ऑल द साइजेस ऑफ द टी शर्ट, सॉरी द प्राइस ऑफ द टी शर्ट्स, देन आई थिंक देयर इज नॉट मच ऑफ अ कॉम्प्लिकेशन. बट द फर्स्ट पार्ट इज एवरीथिंग. ओके ऑलराइट, सो नाउ टेल मी आंसर्स हियर. व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ टी शर्ट्स दैट अभिजीत कैन हैव इफ ही हैज 1300 रुपीज. 1300 रुपीज है. सबसे सस्ता टी शर्ट कौन सा है? सबसे सस्ता टी शर्ट इज बी फोर. Okay, how many t-shirts can he buy? He can buy in 250, he can buy three t-shirts. Another 250, he can buy three t-shirts. Right? He can do like that. Maximum number. Tell me the answer for it. Okay, set 250, two t-shirts are there, okay, which is going to be paid, 330 t-shirt is going to be free. So obviously what happens here, 500 pay kiya, three t-shirt aya, fir se 500 pay kiya, fir three t-shirts aya, six t-shirts ho gaye. How many is left? Which is left with 300 rupees, in which he can take one more t-shirt, and then he has total of seven t-shirts. Okay, so the answer is seven. Clear, Sanket? The answer is 7 here. Okay. Now, how much money does Abhijit have to pay if he selects two t-shirts of brand 6 and one t-shirt of brand 4? Ye toh bahut easy hai. Chalo, iska answer batao. Tell me the answer for this. What's the answer? Brand 7. Two t-shirts of brand 7. Brand 7 is 430. Okay. And you have one t-shirt of brand 4, that is 250. Okay. So it's going to be 430, which is going to be 860. All right. What is the minimum number, minimum amount that Abhijit should have in order to utilize the offer? Minimum amount. Minimum amount is how much? The shirt, which is the most cheapest, is 250. Now, if he wants to avail the amount, he has to have two t-shirts of this, then he can buy the third t-shirt free. So it's 500. Good one. Okay. If Abhijit pays an amount equal to the cost of two t-shirts of brand one, which of the following brand of t-shirts can he get free? Tell me. Equal to two t-shirts of brand one. Brand one is 290. So which t-shirts can he get free? So he's ready to pay an amount of 580. Okay. Which t-shirts can he get? Yes, he can get 6 and 4. Well, that's cheaper than the 290 thing. Okay, so brand 6 or 4. All right, good one. We have already solved three sets. Okay, let us see. Okay, which more set that we can solve. All right, all right, so we did this truth and false teller ones. Okay, this is one more of the similar type, but a little trickier than the previous one. Give it a shot. I'll give you 4 to 5 minutes of time first. Are you guys getting it? Sanket, Bhushan, any answers that you're getting in till now? If you're able to figure out that who is the person such, who is the jhoot person, who is the pehla such, pehla jhoot person. Okay, good one. So yeah, tell me, what's the answer then? Let us have a quick check.
अरुण इज पहला झूठ, भरत
अरुण इज पहला झूठ. अच्छा, दैट
इज, भरत इज झूठ,
मीन्स दिस इज फॉल्स. ओके, दिस इज ट्रू, दिस इज फॉल्स. ओके, हाँ,
भरत इज झूठ,
भरत इज झूठ.
यस,
ओके, चलो.
चित्रा इज सच
चित्रा इज सच,
एंड देविका इज पहला सच.
पहला सच. ओके, चलो, लेट मी क्विकली चेक द डेटा दैट यू आर टेलिंग मी. ऑलराइट, टू सैटिस्फाई वी नीड टू जस्ट हैव क्विक चेक. ओके, जस्ट अ मिनट, लेट मी जस्ट पुट दिस विंडोज इन फाइल. All right, so if you see, this is going to be like this. This is going to be Colombo. Okay, so Aran is from Colombo in that case. This person is from Amsterdam in that case. All right, and I'm from Davos, so this person is from Davos, and this person is from Brussels. Okay. How is this possible? Okay, this person actually this false. Okay, all right. Okay, and Chitra is a jhoot. Chitra is a such. Okay. Okay, yes, I think this that's all good. Okay, Bhushan, have you got the same answer? Okay, sure, we'll go ahead. So this answer that we can definitely write faster now. Amsterdam. Okay, who's from Amsterdam? So we can say that Amsterdam, Chitra is from Amsterdam. Okay, so here we can write Chitra. Who among the four are neither such nor jhoot? Okay, neither such nor jhoot. We know that this person is pehla jhoot. Okay, and this person is pehla sach. So Arun and Devika. Arun and Devika. Which of the following statement is correct? Okay, so I think once you have solved, okay, we can get the entire set correct. Okay, shall we move on to the next set, Sanket? Okay, चलो गुड. तो आई थिंक आगे से कम ट्रूथ फॉल्स वाला सॉल्व हो जाना चाहिए, उसके अंदर इशू नहीं आना चाहिए. ओके, अ स्लाइटली इजियर सेट ओनली, यू कैन गिव इट अ शॉट. दीज आर द क्वेश्चन, यू कैन लुक एट द क्वेश्चंस एंड देन वी कैन लुक एट द मेन पार्ट ऑफ द सेट. ओके, टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट ऑफ दिस. ओके, आई होप यू हैव टेकन इट. चलो ट्राई करो यारा. Yeah, do let me know in case you are stuck. Okay, so let us do it. Okay, easy sir. Actually, we can. Bhushan says, can you show the question? Okay. Okay, for this, in fact, I have the solution here in the picture as well. Okay, you can check this picture. All right. Look at this. So basically what happens, this is the initial position. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay. And then what happens? Okay, then what happens that, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And from the last, okay, things get exchanged, right? Things get like here, you will have 8, you'll have 7, you have 6, you'll have 5, like this, right? And then things will like move in a, again, what a horizontal manner. So 1, and then you will have 8, then you have 2, then you have 7, then you have 3, then you have 6, then you have 4, and then you have 5, like this. So if you see, 8 is what? Harsha. Okay, Harsha comes here. Okay, likewise, you have second Bindiya comes here, seventh was Gauri comes here. Okay, third was Cheryl comes here, sixth was Fatima, she is still there. Okay. And then you have fourth, which was Dipti, she came here. And fifth, Isha came here, likewise. The same thing can be repeated now for next round, next round, next round. And if you see in round four, at the end of round four, you are getting the same sequence as the beginning. You're getting the same sequence. Okay? You're getting the same sequence, exactly same sequence you're getting. Right? Okay. Perfect. So yes, the answer for first question is 4. Yes. At which place is Cheryl before the penultimate? Penultimate round is basically the second last. Okay, this thing. Okay, second last. Second last round starts. So Cheryl is at 8th position. Check this. Check this. Okay. This is going to be your end of round two. Okay. This is here. And sorry. Okay. Yeah. This is a Cheryl is at second position. Perfect. Yes. Yes. End of round three. But the thing is, before the penultimate round starts, now. No, the answer is not second. The answer is 8th only. It is start. So this thing, when the penultimate thing starts, when? Check here, Sanket. Okay. Start, this is end. So start is this. So the answer is 8. How many members come to their original position at least once before they come to, before they all come to their position? How many members come to their original position? If you see, okay. Fatima is one. Okay, who's here? Then apart from this, if you see who else comes in original position, let us check. You have Dipti who comes in. All right, original position. You have see Gauri who comes in. These are two people who come to the original position. Okay, before others came in, Fatima is always there. Okay, Asmita is always there. So there are four people. Four people. You have to count Asmita and Fatima also, because they are also going through this entire formation, na? Okay, and they are coming to their original position at the end of the first round itself. So we'll count. Shuffling is happening here. Okay, for everyone. It's just that after shuffling, Asmita and Fatima still remains in the same position. Okay, so the answer here is 4. Next sequence is designed the following manner. The dancers break into two rows of 4 each. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and here you have, like, say I put a number 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and you have 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, then the following steps, 1 and 2 are different. Okay, all right. In how many rounds will the sequence end? Chalo, what is the answer here? Answer is 2? No. Answer is not 2. Yes, answer is 3. Good one. All right. So I think we have solved good sum 5 sets today. Okay, across 2 hours. Good to know. Okay, and one thing I wanted to ask. Okay, Sanket and Bhushan. So why are people so less in today's class?
Sir, no idea.
So we'll talk to Surya and see what's happening. Anyways, tomorrow morning you again have a class at 11:30. Okay, 11:30 to 1:30. Okay, that is on PNC probability.
Yes, sir.
Okay, all the best. Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.